Can anyone in this room tell me which is the fourth superpower in the world? India? Second chance. The fourth largest superpower in the world is the civil society. Don't forget this. It's you, you, it's you, it may be you. One person, a few people can transform the way world politics and diplomacy goes. You have to stand for the truth and fight for it.
In a moment, I want you to close your eyes. I'm going to count to three. When you open your eyes, you will no longer be high school students. You will be diplomats representing 193 nations with the mission to solve issues ranging from climate change-related health epidemics to shifting geopolitical landscape of oil, amongst others. Ready? Close your eyes. One, two, three. Open your eyes, please. This is real. Welcome to HMUN India 2013.
The power a child has cannot be measured. Today, when we were doing the session, the kind of interaction that we got from students from 10 different countries, I think there were more than 1,000 in the audience. I think it was fantastic. I speak about Gandhi. This time, I had the privilege of speaking about the Boston Tea Party, Mahatma Gandhi's salt satyagraha, and weaving it together with the Civil Rights March on Washington.
How many of you are angry? One. I'm angry. Two. How many of you have been angry in the last 1 week? Nice. It's good to be angry. Because when you're angry, you're alive. What you do with that anger is more important. You can be a Gandhi and change the world. Or you can pick up a gun. Gandhi changed the world with that anger.
I must say that the quality of engagement has been marvelous, because whatever I saw in these small rooms where people were, the students were debating amongst themselves, the quality of debate was a very high standard.
It's actually an initiative that our company, under the brand MUN Cafe, co-hosts along with the Harvard International Relations Council. From last year to this year, we had more delegates. We had a much higher quality in terms of the kind of speakers that we had at the conference. So that's what our endeavor will be, have better quality of committees, increase the level of debate, and we try and increase the level of debate also by bringing in speakers who can give an external perspective, and of course also bringing in the interface where students and businesses can interact.
I think that nowadays children don't get enough exposure that's divergent from the academics, and any form of exposure that has to do with nature has actually been proven to help children in everything from self-esteem, confidence, to their academics itself.
I'll tell you one thing, I've never met more energetic delegates than at HMUN India 2013. This is the first time a delegate's running after me during breaks. They didn't want to take their tea break because they wanted to speak more. It's incredible, just like seeing the enthusiasm of all these delegates.
The Global Village, I got to taste like Russian sweets and Omani sweets from the delegates from Oman. I would never have actually ever gone there or, you know, had a chance to taste them. The Indian night was just amazing, and the delegate dance, well, no words for that, that was awesome.
Next generation to come in here, and to actually engage with what is the United Nations guiding principle, talk about the issues ab initio, you know, from the beginning. I think you're doing the world a big service, giving these kids a forum, giving them a place where they can come out and express themselves, forcing on them the need for rational argument. These are all priceless experiences.
And I think the fact that we have so many young leaders of tomorrow present over here from a number of countries, speaking different languages and dialects, and bringing fresh and diverse perspectives to this conference only highlights the fact that the universe is indeed one family.
After our 2 years of association, it has been a wonderful experience because this has given us an opportunity to interact with the young minds of the country and across the world as well.
What exactly is the essence of education? It is to prepare all of you for tomorrow. According to my perspective, it is to prepare for a quantum leap, to forge ahead, not with a goal, but a very well-defined vision to face the world of not tomorrow, but 30, 40, 50, and years beyond.
The students get to take a lot in terms of global awareness. They get to take a lot in terms of skills, life skills that they require, whether it's debating, whether it's negotiating, and very, very important, the value of compromise, the value of diplomacy. And for me, as a teacher of humanities, that is very, very important, because it's only through these conferences when they actually get to enact diplomacy.
The Harvard MUN is an exceptional opportunity for the students too, because it allows them to experience situations which are worldwide in a single session, or a single session over 3 days.
Other countries, like there were many, there was Singapore, and then just other cities. It's just amazing to see that how many of us share the same ideas, even though we have different languages, different cities and different homes. I guess it brings all together.
It's a golden experience, which you don't get to, anywhere else. MUN, where about 2,000 students are here from all over the country. Out of the country, you tend to learn so much from them. The experienced directors, how much they teach you. It's a mind-blowing experience.
Great experience, and I didn't know anything about MUN before joining in for this one, and now I have realized that it is an important aspect for almost every student of the country.
Now to your right, the next Gandhi could be sitting next to you.